simple obstetrician, but I do know that.
Yeah. Three guys to romance three girls.
Sure. These three girls can get some fellows who will understand them.
And make them feel wanted.
Sure. Restore their ego. Build up their confidence. Make them realize that all men aren't villains.
They'd be cured.
Right.
Then they wouldn't have to go to the doc, right?
Right.
Then I get my doc back, right?
Right.
That's marvelous. Three guys to take care of the three girls. Let's toast to that.
Where are we going to get them?
Let's not toast yet. Where are we going to get them? They have to be a lot of different things, not just plain fellas.
That's right.
Who am I going to get?
Well, you've got to get somebody that's footloose and fancy free. Someone that's carefree, artistic, bohemian, like...
No, not me.
You. There's only one person in the world can do this for you, and that's you.
No, it's not a very good idea.
You want to get Liz to Paris or not?
Well, sure, but to romance three girls at one time.
Yes, you can do it.
Yes, since when?
Oh, come on. We went to college together, remember? There wasn't anything you couldn't do once you put your mind to it.
Yeah, I remember. There's a couple of times when... Hey, I'm out of practice, Ben. I've been going steady.
Well, he'll come back to you. It's like riding a bicycle.
Well... I don't know. I wouldn't know how to go about it. I don't even know anything about it. I don't know their first name.
Well, there, I can help you. I'll get Marilyn to talk to Murphy.
Marilyn?
Marilyn's my secretary.
Oh, yeah.
And they'll get all the information. They're buddies.
You seem awfully happy about this all of a sudden.
Well, it's good for business. I want you and Liz to get married and have lots of babies so I can deliver them. Deliver them. I've got to go. I'm about to have twins.
You've been having much morning sickness?
Speaking of sickness, you better lay off that. Just cool it. That's doctor's orders.
Okay, doctor. I'll cool it. I'll blow on it. That'll cool it.
Make it, Ben. It's too far. I heard these boots, they're killing me. My feet are...
Don't shove, Ben!
Wait, are you going or not?
Yes, I'm going.
Remember, play it cool.
Yeah, I'll remember. Don't worry about it. But you remember what you're supposed to do.
Don't worry about me.
No, I won't. I'm worried about me.
No, I'm worried about you. Because if you... All right, I'm going. Oh, my feet.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Right smart day out. One of them marvelous days where the buffalo roam and the deer and the antelope like to play a lot.
That's terrific. Did you want anything or do you intend to finish your song?
Oh, I see. Deer and the antelope, yeah. Yes, I'd like to get some of this fine smelly perfume for my mother back at the ranch.
Do you have a ranch?
Well, Ryan's got the biggest ranch west of Denver and Chicago. This smelly perfume now.
Where is your ranch?
Oh, Wyoming country. The Wyoming country. Wyoming, near Jackson Hole. You wouldn't know about that being a city slicker.
Oh, yes, I know. Jackson Hole, Wyoming. Sitting Bull country.
Why, I'd be right darned if you didn't know, you little filly. What are you doing, studying your history book?
I see it all in the movies.
In the movies?
Mm-hmm.
Aha. Well, maybe one day you'd like to see it personally, huh?
I beg your pardon.
Oh. Yes, that's fair enough. Well, I guess I'll be moving on. Moseying along, see if there's some...
Excuse me.
Yeah, yeah. Sure thing. Fine, ma'am. Little filly. Well, to tell you the truth, ma'am, let me just tell you that what I'm trying to say is that when I'm out there riding the range, when I'm riding the range all by myself, with no companionship, and just, you know, an occasional prairie dog to keep me company, when I get back to civilization, I just feel uncomfortable with women. It's just that... I just can't, I just don't do too well. Well,
I thought to myself, if I could fix you. And that's why I would, it's a good thing to know that when you're falling too tall to die.
Ringo Raintree.
Why, I don't believe I had the pleasure of meeting up with you, sir.
No, you don't know me. But I know you, Ringo Raintree, king of the cowboys.
Well, yeah.
The greatest cowhand in the West.
Well,
greatest roper. Greatest rider.
I ride into the
greatest bulldogger.
I love to bull.
Fastest gun.
I whip it right out.
I wonder if I could trouble you, Mr. Raintree, to have an autograph. If I could just take an autograph home to my wife and kids, make them happy.
Some youngins, huh? Well, let me find out there. Aren't you laying it on a little thick? I see. It'd be my pleasure to ride down in here.
It's the happiest day of my life.
Spell Raintree.
Write anything.
Anything. You write anything when people want your moniker.
Wonderful.
And there it is. There's my moniker.
Oh. Ringo Raintree. And there he is. Talking to you, little lady. You from the big city, just like he was a plain, ordinary person. If you could get him to tell you about his life down in West, it'd be fabulous. And tell you about some of his fabulous experiences, it would be fabulous. Just fabulous.
Oh, shucks.
Sir, as a fellow American, I salute you. God bless you. Ringo Raintree!
Now, do you remember everything I told you?
Yeah, I remember everything.
What's her name?
Susan Manning.
Susan Manning. Right, and what does she do?
She runs around the park every day.
Right, and what does she like?
She likes judo, karate, she breaks boards.
Right.
Yeah, wrong.
This whole thing feels wrong, Ben.